Hello students, welcome to our channel SD Biology classes. In our last video, we have discussed about ecosystem, its structure and function. We have seen that the ecosystem has biotic and abiotic components. The biotic components of the ecosystem include plants, animals and microorganisms. The variety of living organisms present in our surrounding or present in the ecosystem is called as the biodiversity. In this chapter, we are going to know about biodiversity and its conservation. So students, let's start it. So students, today we are going to know about the biodiversity. What is biodiversity? What are the different types of biodiversity? That is species diversity, genetic diversity and ecological diversity. We will also learn about the types of ecological diversity and the most important part of the video, that is the trivia portion that includes some important question based on today's lesson. So let's learn it. Okay students, first of all we will know about biodiversity. The word biodiversity means, bio means life and diversity means variety. So the variety of living organisms within the species, between the species and within an ecosystem or different ecosystem is called as the biodiversity. The term was given by Walter Rosen and was popularized by Edward Wilson. So the biodiversity can be defined as the occurrence of different types of genes, gene pools, species, habitats and ecosystem in a particular place. Now students, there is a question that what is gene pool? Gene pool is the collection of genes or genetic information within a population of a species. So in a species or in a population of a specific species like deer, in a population of deer, the variety of deer we can see. So this variety is occurred due to the variation in the genetic information. So all the collection or all set of genes in the deer population is called as the gene pool. Now what are the different types of biodiversity? It is mainly of three types: the genetic diversity, diversity in the gene level, species diversity and ecological diversity. So we will know about these three types of diversity one by one. Students, see here we have a picture of dog population. We can see different types of dogs over here. So why we will get these variations in the dog species? It is due to the differences or variety in the genetic constitution, that is genetic information present within the dog species. So we can say that the variety in genetic information contained in the organisms or the variety in genetic information contained in the species is called as the genetic diversity. For example, in India, 1000 variety of mangoes we will get. Even we can see that one medicinal plant that is called as Rowlfia, species can be different. In case of Rowlfia serpentina, Rowlfia vomitoria, we will get the chemical substance from it that is called as reserpine. Now, the reserpine that we obtained from the different variety of Rowlfia are genetically different from each other. That is, the chemical constituents, main chemical constituents of reserpine can be vary from one variety to another variety of Rowlfia. So, this is due to the changes or due to the genetic constitution present in the different variety of the Rowlfia. So this is the example of the genetic diversity. Now another type of biodiversity or the diversity in the living organism, when we see it in the species level, it can be called as the species diversity. Suppose we visit a forest, we can see different types of animals and also different types of plants over there, like deer, bear, tiger. These are the different wild animals that we can see in the forest. These variations, this type or these different types of animals we will get in a forest ecosystem due to the diversity in the species level. So we can say that the variety of species and their relative abundance in a particular region is called as the species diversity. For example, the amphibian present in the Western Ghat is greater than the amphibian present in the Eastern Ghat. That means what? That is the amphibian, this group or different types of amphibians, different species of amphibians present in Western Ghat is more than the different species of amphibian present in the Eastern Ghat. So we will get different variety of living organism at the species level. So this is another type of biodiversity. Now we will see about the ecological biodiversity. The ecological diversity is also called as the diversity in ecosystem level. In our surrounding, we can see different habitats as well as we can see different ecosystem also, like the forest ecosystem, desert ecosystem, pond ecosystem, ocean ecosystem. In these cases, what happens? Each and every different types of ecosystem include different types of biotic and abiotic components. So the variety of living organisms we can see in different types of ecosystem, and that's why we can differentiate or we can classify the biodiversity at the ecosystem level also, that is called as the ecological diversity. Now the ecological diversity can be classified into three categories according to Whittaker. What are those? The alpha diversity, beta diversity and gamma diversity. The alpha diversity refers as the diversity among the living organism in a community of the habitat. For example, if we consider the forest habitat, we can see the plant community as well as the animal community in the forest. Now, if we consider only the plant community, different types of plants are there, different varieties of plants are there. Now, we consider, suppose the pine trees there. And the number of pine trees in the forest may be 5. So, the alpha diversity of the pine tree species can be expressed in terms of number of pine trees. So, the alpha diversity of the pine tree in this case will be 5. So, another type of ecological diversity is beta diversity. It refers to the diversity among the living organism that share more than 2 habitats. How can we express beta diversity? If we consider habitat A1 and habitat A2, and the total number of species in A1 habitat is S1, and total number of species in A2 habitat is S2, and the common species in both the habitat or the species which share both the habitat A1 and A2, that can be expressed as C. So we can express the beta diversity of that region in the following way, that is S1 minus C plus S2 minus C. So we have to exclude the common species that share both the habitats A1 and A2. Then we will get the total variety of the living organisms that present in habitat A1 and habitat A2, and that is nothing but the beta diversity. So another type of ecological diversity is the gamma diversity. If we consider a large geographical area, we will see different habitats there, that is A1, A2, A3. And there we will see the alpha diversity as well as the beta diversity, that is the variety of living organisms in these different types of habitat. Now, if we consider all the habitats and also all the ecosystem as well as the variety of living organism in all ecosystem in the large geographical region, it can be expressed in terms of gamma diversity. So, these are the three different types of ecological diversity. Now, students, we have learned about alpha, beta and gamma diversity. Here we have the comparison of alpha, beta and gamma diversity. First of all, alpha diversity is expressed in terms of number of species present in a habitat, whereas beta diversity is expressed in terms of ratio between alpha diversity and the regional diversity. The total diversity of a landscape is expressed as the gamma diversity. Another comparison among these three different types of diversity is that the alpha diversity refers at the local measures of a habitat, whereas the beta diversity of a species is referred as the diversity of species between two different habitats, and the gamma diversity refers as the sum total of all diversity in a landscape. The alpha diversity is the smallest unit of the diversity, whereas the gamma diversity, as it includes all the diversity, all the different types of organisms in different habitats in a large geographical area, so the gamma diversity is the largest unit of the biodiversity. So here we have the comparison between alpha, beta and gamma diversity. So students, here we have some questions based on today's video, today's lesson. See, what type of biodiversity we can see when we see or when we consider the strains of rice in India. In India, we are getting almost 50,000 different strains of rice. What kind of biodiversity it shows? So rice, that is scientifically it is called as Oryza sativa. In this species, we are getting 50,000 different variety. So this variation within the same species occurs due to the differences in the genetic information. So the diversity is shown in the genetic level. So what kind of diversity it shows? It shows genetic diversity. It shows genetic diversity. So here another question we have. That is, estuaries and alpine meadows in India. What type of biodiversity represented by estuaries and alpine meadows in India? Estuaries and alpine meadows are two different types of ecosystem. So here we are getting the variety at the ecosystem level. So simply it shows the ecosystem diversity or ecological diversity. Now, what is the another name of IUCN? All of us know the full form of IUCN. What is it? The International Union for Conservation of Nature and Natural Resources. But what is the other name of IUCN? The other name of IUCN is World Conservation Union. World Conservation Union. Now another question we have, that is, when do we observe World Wildlife Week? It is observed in the first week of October. It is observed in the first week of October. Now, the name the most biodiversity rich zone in India. The most biodiversity rich zone in India is Western Ghat. Do you know the Biodiversity Day? The Biodiversity Day is celebrated, or we observe the Biodiversity Day on 29th December. So here we have some important questions based on today's lesson, and also we have discussed about the different types of diversity, and also we have the comparison between alpha, beta and gamma diversity. So from today's video we have learned about biodiversity, its types. In the next video we will know about the pattern of diversity and also the cause of loss of biodiversity. Thank you.